A very good morning to all. How are you? Fine. Good. Then what we studied in last class? Flipping and adding. So we can discuss a story-like problem given in our textbook. In our textbook, you can see a story-like problem in page number 27. So I will read for you. Rohit has 4 marbles. Gautam has 3 marbles. How many marbles do they have? Rohit has 4 marbles. Gautam has 3 marbles. Then we have to find the total number of marbles. Okay. Then Rohit has 4 marbles. Then Gautam has 3 marbles. Then we have to find the total number of marbles. Then we are going to add 4 plus 3 and the sum will be the total number of marbles. Then we can draw 4 ones blocks, then 3, 1, 2, 3. It is already given in your textbook, 4 marbles plus 3 marbles. Then we can count how many marbles are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 marbles. So we got, there are total 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Then, now Rohit has 3 marbles. Rohit had only 3 marbles. And Gautam has 4 marbles. How many marbles do they have? We can check. Here, in next, Rohit has 3 marbles. Then, Gautam has 4. Then we have to find how many marbles do they have. So, we have to add these numbers. Okay. Then, what is 3 plus 4? We can check. 1, 2, 3 plus 1, 2, 3, 4. It's already given in your textbook. 3 marbles plus 4 marbles. There are 3 marbles given here and 4 marbles. Then we have to find the total. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So there are 7 marbles. There are 7 marbles total. So we got here the sum is 7 and here also. So here the addends are changed. Addends are flipped. Then the sum remains same. The sum remains same. So the no change in the sum. Even the addends are changed. Okay. Now, can you say the sum of 12 plus 3 quickly? We always drawing the place value blocks to find the sum. Here we didn't get the answer quickly. So, we have to find the sum easily and quickly without drawing any place value blocks. Shall we practice? Yes. How it possible? How it possible? We can think the numbers and we can add numbers mentally in our mind. Then we will get the answer or we will get the sum quickly. Isn't? So shall we practice? Yes. That is we are going to study in fourth lesson. Lesson number 4, adding mentally. Lesson number 4, adding mentally. Okay, shall we do? Now, we are going to find the sum of 12 plus 3. without drawing any place value blocks. So we can count the numbers in our mind. So first, you have to think about the bigger number. You have to think about the bigger number. Which is the bigger number here? 12 or 3? Yes, 12, right? So think about the number 12. Okay. Then count on in our mind by as many as the smaller number. Okay. So here the bigger number is 12. So in our mind think about the number 12. Then the smaller number is 3. Then we are going to count the number as many as the smaller number. So here there are 3 numbers. So we are going to count this number as many as these numbers. Okay. So here number 12. Then we are going to count 13, 14, 15. And the number that we count in the last is the sum. Which number we got? Which number we count last? 13, 14, 15. What we got? Number 15, right? So here we got the sum is 15. Okay. So shall we do another example? Yes. 9 plus 3. Which is the bigger number here? 3? No, 9. Very good. So think about number 9. Then we have to count after these numbers as many as this number, that is 3. So 9, after 9, 10, 11, 12. Which is the last number we got? Number 12. So we got the sum 12. Okay. We can do another example. 11 plus 4. 11 plus 4. Here the bigger number is 11. Then we can count as many as the smaller number. So here the smaller number is 4. Then after 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Here we got 12, 13, 14 and 15. So which is number that we got last? We got number 15. So here the sum is 15. Then what is 2 plus 9? What is 2 plus 9? We can count in our mind. So which is the bigger number here? 2 or 9? 9. So we can think the number 9 in our mind. We can count as many as the number 2. We can use our fingers. Okay. So here instead of writing the numbers here, we can use our fingers. Okay. So I'm thinking about number 9. Then I can take the smaller number in my hand. Here 2. Then I'm thinking about number 9. And after 9, 10, 11. What we got? Number 11. So 2 plus 9 equals 11. The sum of 2 plus 9 is 11. So we can write 11 here. Shall we do one more? Yes. What is 30 plus 5? 30 plus 5. Which is the bigger number here? 30. Good. Then we can think about the number 30. Then which is smaller number here? 5. Then we can take 5 in our hand. Then after 30, 40, please count with me. 40, 50, 60, 70, 80. What we got? 80. So we can write 18 here. Then we got the sum of 13 plus 5 is 80. Okay. Now, can I ask you a question? How many more than 5 is 15? How many more than 5 is 15? So, how we get? Can we think about the bigger number? No. Why? Because the question is not asking for add. The question is not asking to add. Here we have to find the numbers in between 5 and 15. How many numbers in between 5 and 15? Question asks for how many more than 5 is 15. Then we can think about the number 5 first. Count on until we reach number 50. So, are you ready? Yes. We can think about number 5. Then 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. We reached it number 50. Then how many numbers we got? 5 and 5. Then we got 10. We got number 10. Then how many more than 5 is number 15? We got 10 more than the number 50. So we can write 5 plus 10 equals 15. We can write 5 plus 10 equals 15. Okay. Then, how many more than 2 is 8? How many more than 2 is 8? This is our question. So, think about number 2. We have to find the numbers, total numbers between 2 and 8. Then, we have to think about number 2 first. Here, the question is not asking to add. Here, we have to find the total numbers in between 2 and 8. So, we can think about the smaller number. Here, which is smaller number? 2. We can count until we reach number 8. So, think about number 2 first. Then 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We reach number 8. Then how many numbers here? 5, 6. So we got 6 more than the number 2. So we got the number 8 is 6 more than the number 2. Now we can write 2 plus 6 equals 8. We can write 2 plus 6 equals 8. Okay. Now we can discuss our worksheet.
In our practice question, first question, count forward and fill in the blanks. 12 is the first number. Then we know the number after 12. Then after that number, like that. You can write all the numbers and fill in the blanks. Second question, fill in the blanks. So you have to find the sum of all these numbers. Third question, how many more than 15 is 18? So first, you have to think the smaller number. Then count on until we reach number 80. Then the total number that we got is the answer. In your workbook, first question is count forward and write the numbers in the boxes. It is the same pattern of questions that given in your PQ. In the second question, you have to find the sum of those numbers and match to the right answer. In the third question, how many more than 11 is 18? It is same as the question given in your PQ. Then you have to think the smaller number, that is 11. Then after 11, you have to count down until we reach number 80. Then the number that we got is the answer. Now, block 5 is completed. Then you can do the additional practices also. First question, choose the correct number to complete the addition sentence. So you have to find the sum of those numbers, then choose the right answer from the bracket. And second question, what is the sum when 10 is added to each given number? So you have to find the sum when we add 10 to the numbers 4, 7 and 9. Here we have to find what is the sum of 4 plus 10 and 7 plus 10 and 9 plus 10. In third question, draw place value blocks to find the answer. We can take the question number A as an example, 7 plus 11. So first, draw number 7 and 11, then put these blocks together to find the answer. In fourth question, pick the addition sentence that has the same sum as 14 plus 3. So if the sum of 14 plus 3 and 13 plus 5 is equal, then A is the answer. So if sum of 14 plus 3 and 3 plus 14 is equal, then B is the answer. Like that you can do. In the fifth question, add numbers mentally and match with their sum. So you have to add those numbers mentally and match the correct answer. Sixth question is fill in the blanks question. I think it is easy for you. Seventh question, question number A. A baker made 14 loaves of bread in the morning. He made 5 loaves in the evening. How many loaves did he bake in total? So we have to find the total number of loaves he made. So we have to add 14 to the number 5. Question number B. Asha made 11 jute baskets and Sunil made 8 jute baskets. How many baskets did they both make in total? Here also, we have to find the total number of jute baskets made by both. So, we can add 11 to the number 8 to find the total number of jute baskets. Eighth question is the same pattern of question that we discussed earlier.
Now, we completed block 5. So, don't forget to do all your worksheets and send to me. Okay. Then, after doing all this, you can do the additional practices. It will help you for coming exam. Okay. So, we are winding up in today. Thank you. Bye.